In 2024, a ton of new solar gear was released. Some truly impactful products hit the market, and we were thankful enough to be able to have tested out a lot of them here at the lab. Some of them went really well, and some of them were complete garbage. And today, we want to share our experience with you guys and our unbiased, unsponsored favorites of 2024. So welcome back to the lab, where our opinions cannot be bought. Today, we're going to cover our favorite battery, inverter, panels, and other accessories. We've already got two videos that we made dedicated to power stations in the small power station section and the large power station section. So if you're looking just for portable power stations, go check out one of those. We've also been slaving away and negotiating hardcore for you guys to get some really good discounts coming up for Black Friday. So take notes during today's video. Make sure you guys are subscribed so you don't miss our Black Friday video, where we have some exclusive discounts that you won't be able to find anywhere else on the internet to truly, as long as we're not being lied to, give you guys the best prices on some of this gear all year. First up, we are taking a look at the EG4 LL and LifePower 4 batteries. They're pretty close to the same thing. The LifePower 4 is just the more basic version of the LL. These are 48 volt, 100 amp hour batteries. They also come in 24 and 12 volt options. The LL is actually EMP protected straight from the factory. It's a really simple battery. It performed really well in all of our testing. It has a ton of communication. It can work with a ton of other equipment, and it's just honestly really, really easy to set it up and get it going. The build quality is great. It's one of the only batteries that's actually UL listed, which makes it legal to install in certain places. It's got fire arresters and temperature sensors and everything built into the battery. And if you're like me and you like your batteries having a screen so you can just kind of walk up, touch wherever the buttons are, and see what's going on at a glance. The LL comes with a screen. It doesn't add a ton of cost, but you can also get the LifePower 4 with no screen, saves you about $100. Works just as well as basically the same battery. You can also grab the EG4 cabinet, which we just set up recently, and it's actually a really nice cabinet, super easy to set up. Very clean, and honestly doesn't cost that much for what you're getting. But overall, we've tested a ton of these server rack batteries this year, and honestly, there was only a few that really stood out. And speaking of server rack batteries, this is pretty much the only other one that made the list. This is the Rich Solar Alpha 5 Pro. Looks really, really nice. It's slimmer, it's sleeker. The Rich cabinet though, it's kind of cool, dude. The doors come off all the sides. Like, it's a much cooler cabinet in my opinion. But anyways, this battery performed really well, actually. It arguably performed just a tiny bit better than the EG4 ones. It's also UL listed, so you can legally install it in a lot of places like California, because you're hosers. It's easier to pick up and move. It has little side handles if that's something you need to do. I really like the quick disconnects. It makes everything really, really easy. You just pop it on, they spin around, rotate freely, so you never have like to loosen and tighten your wires to figure it out. The overall build quality on this was actually also really, really good. I really like the touch screen. It's a lot more interactive. There's a lot more information on there. And honestly, the price of this is pretty freaking good. And moving off of the server rack batteries, probably the one you didn't expect. This is the Big Battery Husky 2. This is a golf cart battery. That's what it's sold as. But this is actually a really, really sick battery. This is 48 volts, 100 amps. My favorite part about this is that all these plates, they're all modular and you can unbolt them and rebolt them anywhere. So yes, this is meant for a golf cart, but you could easily bolt this to the floor of your boat. You could bolt this to the floor of your RV and like permanently have it there without having weird straps and shit going all over it. It's also, I believe, IP65 rated. So you actually could put this thing like in your boat or whatever. Server rack batteries, not so much. That's why it kind of looks like such a doink, but I mean, it's a really, really practical battery, even though it looks a little weird. It performed really well in all of our tests. It still has communication ports. It's overall just like a random, but really, really cool product that I recommend looking into. Next up is the EG4 Power Pro battery. This thing is an absolute beast. It weighs 300 pounds. You will not catch me putting it on a table. That's for sure. It's a 14 kilowatt hour battery bank, 280 amps, and it comes in an indoor and an outdoor version. It's got a little bracket so you can mount it up to the wall, and it's honestly just a kick-ass battery. It's designed for bigger applications, so you can have like multiple batteries against the wall outside. But a huge pro that we find to that battery is that it would actually make a much smaller system, like a small off-grid cabin, a greenhouse, even just like a little shed or a small garage. It would work really well in there because it's such a slim, narrow profile when you compare it to like a server rack cabinet. You get a ton of storage in a really small package. It performs really, really well. It's UL listed, it has a ton of safety features like the rapid shutdown. It's another product from EG4 that was EMP protected for no additional fee. And if you don't need to put it outside, you can scoop the indoor version. It actually saves you a couple hundred bucks each battery, which is a pretty good deal. Getting started with the EG4 3000 watt little yellow Pikachu inverter. This thing is so simple, it hurts. It performs extremely well. It's so easy to set up. It's easy to navigate. It's easy to understand. It's very beginner friendly and it works really, really well. It performed really well in all of our testing. It can surge a little bit beyond what it's rated for. You can actually expand on them as well, which is nice. So if you want to start now and grow later, you can get this and then get another one and then you could do 240, then you can run 6,000 watt. Tons of use cases for this guy. It's quiet, it's small, put it in an RV, put it wherever you want. It's a really, really good, small, and aggressively priced, honestly, unit. And the other tiny little inverter that we would actually recommend is this guy. This is the Rich Solar 3000 watt inverter. It's been out of office for a while. We don't know where this guy went. When we made a video on it, it was a wicked price. And I think a lot of people bought them. And I don't know that they ever replenished it, but if you find one of these things for the price you're gonna pay, or at least the sale price it was on, it's just as simple as the EG4. It's honestly a lot quieter than the EG4, but that comes at the cost of not having a dust shield. So if you're running this in like a dirtier environment, you are gonna end up pulling crap inside of it. So the EG4 one does keep everything inside a little bit cleaner. This one's also easier to get solar input into. The EG4 though is easier to put more into. Creeping up in inverter sizes a little bit, the 6000 XP, hands down, probably my favorite inverter that we've gotten this year. It's just so ready to go. You don't need to buy any additional breakers or anything like that. All your breakers for your battery, for your grid, for your load, everything are right here and easily accessible right from the front of this unit. A lot of other units, you're gonna have to actually run an inline fuse and mount it like on the wall below it or something like that. So this actually saves you a bunch of money up front from having to do these things separately. The solar input is bigger than the output of this. This is a 6,000 watt inverter. You can put 8,000 watts into it. So if you have this hooked up properly, it should never be able to die even when you're running it at full tilt, which is a huge pro. It's also just really easy to hit the voltage requirements for the solar. Setting it up was easy. There's a couple drawbacks like the screen and stuff, not my favorite. It's a little bit boomery, I guess. I don't know what you would call it, but it's just not like, you can't see everything you want on one screen. It's like if you want to see wattage input, you got to go to one screen. And then if you want to see wattage output, you got to cycle to get to there, but then you lose your wattage up here. And it's just like, I wish it was a little bit better, but at the end of the day, for like easy setup, get your settings figured out, call Signature Solar, ask them like the three questions you have that I had at least trying to hook this thing up. They'll direct you to the settings, you get it dialed in, you're done, you're good to go. We really like this guy. Super low idle consumption, pretty much as the little 3000 we just talked about. It's got separate grid and generator inputs. It does 120 or 240 for output. Next up, we got the Bright Mount. This is another EG. EG4 did a really good way of weaseling their way into our favorite products this year, but I guess that's like kudos to them for having good product. The Bright Mount is our favorite ground mount right now. This thing is super easy to set up. I set it up, I think, inside of an hour. It's meant to hold four 400 watt panels that are like tall. Our 400 watt panels that we had at the time were really wide, so we couldn't get them on there. So we threw on some 200 watt panels. The only thing I would recommend is that they include more T-brackets so you can mount more panels. If we didn't have extra T-brackets laying around, we would only have been able to put four 200 watt panels on that thing. We actually have it outside with six 200 watt panels right now, but regardless, it's a sick, sturdy, solid mount. We have it on wheels because we've kind of been, you know, dragging it around a little bit. It was in the garage for a bit, now it's in the yard. We had a windstorm flip the whole thing right on its face because it's not properly secured. And it's completely fine, like nothing bent, everything's in good shape. Cannot say that for all of the solar arrays that were flipped over that day. It's also not much more than getting one on Amazon, and the Amazon ones sag straight out of the box. They don't have enough mid legs to keep everything level. This one has tons of, it's a great ground mount, okay? We don't need to over explain it. It's a simple product, it does really good. When it comes to solar panels, our favorite panel this year was the Sirius 415 watt. This thing looks unreal. It's the all black, it's bifacial, and it is really, really cheap. It's $187, which is like nothing for a 415 watt bifacial panel. That's a steal is what it is. They're an American company, solid results in the backyard, generate lots of power for the boys. And in our experience, it's always shipped really, really well. We've never had, you know, solar panels are kind of, that's one of their main problems is damage during shipping. Our experience was really, really good. Anyways, these are some of our favorite products that we put to the test during our first year in 2024. We are currently working on some bigger stuff so we can bring you the 18 kilowatt size inverters and more fun shit for next year. So make sure you guys are subscribed if you like getting honest feedback and real opinions, not ones that people are paid to promote and fluff that, you know, some products honestly just don't deserve. So that is all we got for you guys. We got links in the description for all the products we talked about today, as well as discount codes, but I would hold off until the Black Friday because there's gonna be some wicked sales there. So make sure you guys are subscribed so you don't miss the Black Friday video. That is all we got for you guys. I will catch you next time. Peace out and stay charged.